Dr. S.S. Kalbath, who is 68 years old, served as a senior scientific officer in the Central Food Technological Research Institute, Mysore, from 1956 to 1963, and later joined the Hindustan Lever Limited, where he rose to be the head of the Engineering Science Division. Feeling the urge for enthusing villages to take advantage of scientific technology for rural development, he settled on a barren 5-acre plot of land at Parbal in Pune district and established the Vignan Ashram in the year 1983. His work is a one-man mission of a radical structural reform in the educational system. Both formal and non-formal training are provided. The teaching material and methods have been documented, demonstrated, and used in such a manner that the new technologies are practically applied in a large number of schools in Maharashtra. Necessary changes have been made to suit the new devices in the curriculum of studies. The system integrates education and rural development to the process of learning while doing on the one hand and using it through skilled practice for providing community services. These services include locating underground water through electrical measurement, which was done by postgraduate students and is now done by school-level students. Even the instruments required for this purpose are designed in the rural technology project. School-level students have also been trained for offering simple medical services like detecting anemia, microscopic examination of specimens, and also for water divining. The success and the practicability of these innovative practices has led the government of Maharashtra to approve the inclusion of the rural technology course in a large number of technical educational schools in the state. The greatest merit of Dr. Kalbagh's experiments and innovation is their acceptability to the rural people, who are personal witnesses to a remarkable transformation of the methodologies of rural development.
I thank all of you. I feel very honored. I have a dream which I will take this opportunity to elaborate. If talent is wealth, then we have a potential mine of wealth lying unused. 75% of our youth drop out of the school before they reach the school final. Half of those who pass become educated unemployed. This makes about 3 to 4 crores of youth every year. Are they a burden on our society? Not at all. They learn through life and become farmers, factory workers, truck drivers, small traders, masons, electricians, and so many other trades. Go to any corner shop or a workshop and you will find them. They form most of the nation's workforce and produce a good part of the GDP. Their world is the real India, as Professor Yashpal calls it. The educational system calls them dropouts, but they learnt in the university of life. My idea is based on Gandhiji's Nahi Talim. Use craft as a medium for education. Why not we attach a farm and a workshop to every school, like we attach a medical hospital to a medical college? If we can give in the school itself both thinking skills and living skills, they may never need to be dropouts. Learning while doing, we find, makes many difficult subjects easy to understand. And a mix of skills relevant to everyday life can be fitted in the school syllabus at a very modest cost. Such a school can give many services to the community at an affordable cost. The school not only gives such services at a very low cost, but improves the quality of education and saves on education cost as well. We have shown the feasibility of this Nahi Talim principle in the modern technology context. My dream is that our little effort will help in making this currently underutilized human resource into a new gold mine for the nation. Jai Hind.